recent attack in Libya. Mike Cody has a question. Again, this one goes to you, Mr. Bass.
Mr. Bass, Senator Kelly Ayotte and others have called for a congressional hearing to find exactly what happened in Libya 2 months ago with the murder of U.S. Ambassador Chris Stevens and three other Americans. Do you think the federal government was incompetent in how it responded to the attack?
I think it's more than that, Mike. There will be a full investigation of this incident, and I regret the fact that the truth is probably going to be punted until after next Tuesday. But I served on intel, and it always irritates me a little bit when senior officials throw the intelligence community under the bus, which is what they did before they tried to claim that it was caused by a movie that was produced in California. The Obama administration knew what was going on. They knew it was a terrorist attack. They did not supply the ambassador with the security that he needed, and they tried to cover it up. And I think in the end, we will find out exactly to what extent this happened and what occurred. But the biggest tragedy of all here is the fact that these four brave patriots were killed, and it was unnecessary. It could have been avoided. And again, like many of these issues, it's not so much the events, which are tragic, but it's the fact that this administration tried to obfuscate the real facts and should have put them on the table in the very beginning. And we will find out over the coming months just how serious a problem this was.
Ms. Custer, how do you think the administration has handled the attacks?
Well, I think that I agree with Congressman Bass that the real tragedy was the loss of these four patriots, particularly Ambassador Chris Stevens, who had a remarkable background in the Arab world. He'd been in the Peace Corps in Morocco and knew the language and knew the people. Those are the types of people we need overseas to be keeping the rest of us safe, frankly. I will say there was a very lengthy timeline that came out yesterday that I read with interest, and it's very obvious that there was no stand-down order. I think this has been politicized in the presidential race, and it's unfortunate. Certain media outlets mentioning that help was not sent immediately. It's clear from the timeline that everything was done that was possible to protect these people. I do think we need increased security for all of our embassies, and I think going forward that would be the major change in policy. It'll be expensive, but it'll be absolutely worth it.